think the response for Enter Year Two and Enter Saki has been incredible, actually. We came in last year with a new drink, with the hype of Enter. And I think, luckily, a lot of the people who come to the island are actually open to finding something new out. I think actually people, they want to go home, saying that they went to a new party, they had this new experience, they met some new people. So it's actually a perfect island to introduce anything new.
Saki didn't even exist in Ibiza until last year with Enter and with Richie.
When I met Richie and discovered his absolute love and his thorough knowledge of all things Japanese, I was super impressed.
It's hard to explain, really. It's like there's a vibe at Enter that I've not felt at any other party.
This year, we're really lucky that some friends of ours were putting together a new, incredible restaurant called Saka. And the idea of Enter Saki, Enter Saka, and this collaboration came. And it has given us basically a home for Enter Saki 7 days a week.
I feel that Saka and Enter are two kindred spirits. Who operate within this beautiful environment of Ibiza.
We wanted to make something that we felt was world class, and you know, we saw the way Ibiza has been going, and Richie was doing exactly the same thing in a parallel line, and it's been a really, really beautiful partnership thus far.
Tonight's special event at Saka is a great way for us to bring people deeper into the whole idea of Enter Saki and the Sakis that we have here on the island.
This first Enter Saki event was about pairing the food at Saka with the Saki menu, and getting people to, you know, getting people to take smaller tasting plates and work through it and really experience the Saki.
Tonight has been specifically about the producers of the Saki coming in from Japan. Obviously Saka being one of only two places that you can drink this product outside of Japan in the world.
Fujioka-san and I were able to go around to the people, you know, tasting and listening to what they were, you know, the people were saying, their opinions, even giving them some other special sakis that we may bring next year, and learning more really about what people think of sake in Europe.
Ah, 日本酒ってみんな経験してくれて楽しんでくれてるんだなっていうのをすごく感じました今年。
No matter what you say, sake is a drink made in Japan for Japanese people. So we're actually bringing it completely out of context, not only to Europe, but into a nightclub, or into this beautiful Ibiza setting, this restaurant outside under the stars. We're trying to engage, we're trying to educate, but at the same time, like with Enter and everything I do with music, also have fun at the same time.
It's very far away from Japan here, and kind of, you know, encounter Japanese culture here again. So that's amazing. And the people are enjoying it.
It's a combination between music and, in this case, food. It's very, very new, different. And I think it's a very good thing for the island.
People like Richie Houghton, who brings something else, you know, not only a DJ who plays music, but he brings also sake to Europe, to United States.
Ever since the first time I went to Japan, I felt some kind of connection. The way they live with tradition and technology, their balance within life, and especially in design, and their aesthetic, really kind of spoke to me about what I was trying to do with my music, the idea of reduction and minimalism. And I think, you know, bringing that mentality or that ethos and aesthetic to the island through Saki totally makes sense with Enter.
For me, Richie's, whatever he does, is attention to detail. Whether it be like putting on a big live show, whether it be putting on his own night, whether it be his DJ sets, whether it be the whole food concept, whatever it is, it's attention to detail.
I know he's been interested in Saki for so many years, and like music and sourcing music, it's kind of nice to see him venture out into, you know, kind of sourcing his other great passion.
I've been to Ibiza for like 10 years, and I don't think I've ever seen Saki on the island until 2 years ago. I ended up with the booth with Richie at Cocoon, And he said, "Do you drink sake?" And I said, "Oh, wow, that would be amazing." And then he had an entire little sake set up in the back of the booth.
I think tying electronic music and my DJ friends and the people around our culture into sake actually makes sense.
I'm not a big sake fan from the beginning, but I've learned over the last 10 years to drink it. I've tried quite a lot of it. I don't know that much about it, but it's definitely something I enjoy drinking when I do. It's different somehow, enhances the food, and makes the culinary experience something quite special.
You know, it's an amazing product. It's an amazing, amazing product. And sake is an amazing, amazing drink. And it's, you know, and it's lovely that Richie is just kind of making it more available and putting it in front of people and not doing it from a kind of cynical commercial perspective. He's actually doing it from a loving perspective. And then when you do that, hopefully at the back end, you get the right results.
I think people in Japan find it quite amusing that some white guy from Europe has come in and started to kind of shake them up about sake. You know, I'm the DJ who has sake next to me, not cranberry juice and vodka or anything. That's what I request. And the more I've done that, really over the last 10 years, the more my Japanese friends and my Japanese fans have started to kind of actually get back into sake.
和食以外のフードであったり、そのエンターテインメントっていう世界から日本酒が入ってきている今の現状が僕にとっては夢のような世界で、それをまた現地の人たちが楽しんでいる状況を僕が実際に見て、ちょっとかあの鳥肌が立つような、こんな世界が日本酒もあるんだって本当にちょっと今感動します。
The last 2 years have been incredible with the Intersaki project on Ibiza, but now we hope to take that more global. There's so many places where I'm traveling, I'm DJing, we're doing international shows, and would like to take Intersaki through the world more and start to work with other breweries. You know, Soku is very close to my heart. They have their own identity, much like a record label has their own sound. Soku has their own taste. But there's other smaller breweries that would like to work with and kind of build an introductory portfolio of sakes. So you can come to us, try different things, find what taste is good for you, what particular bottle or what particular brewery, and then be able to find more information about that and follow and perhaps get sucked into a deeper world of Japanese sake.